fighting for justice for her little girl Zara.
My belief of that meeting was a whole waste of time.
Coming face to face with the health minister almost a week after the toddler lost her life at the Queensland Children's Hospital, not long after her mother invoked Ryan's rule.
I think it was really important to sit down and hear from Carly directly about her experiences with our health system.
Speaking behind closed doors only after Carly shared her frustrations with 7 News last night.
I went there for answers to see where the investigation was up to and to ask questions, and it was just told to me pretty much that that's all up to the review panel.
I want answers. The hospital staff also want answers. So there is a process. It does have to run its course.
A process which will take at least 8 weeks.
Why did they give her oxycodone? Why didn't they call me? Why didn't they notify me that my child had gotten worse when I left her?
As Carly questions why doctors couldn't do more for Zara.
Any previous health issues before we went in on the 25th of March didn't have any contribution to Zara's death.
We talked about helping her get access to the medical records for her daughter as well.
Carly wants to see Ryan's rule strengthened or Zara's rule introduced, which would see an ICU doctor called in when a parent deems their child critical.
I want to build on what they've built.
And if they do think there's merit in that, then of course I'm happy to consider that.
Regardless, nothing can ease Carly's pain.
You can say sorry as many times as you want, but your system and your hospital took my daughter.
Anna McGraw, 7 News.